You thought people only rule the world, didn't you? Well, think again. Insects might have a different opinion, not least because they outnumber people by 200 million to 1 and form 50% of the known living species on this planet. Yep, that's right. Welcome to another edition of Whack and Epified. Today we get talking about Earth's huge insect population and the many ways that they affect our lives. One of the biggest reasons there is such a variety of insects and bugs in the world is because they are tough beings. Over the millions of years that they've been around, they've learned to survive changes in habitat, all kinds of predators, and yes, even us, humans. Insects make a lot of difference in our lives, especially when they get too close. Just ask those battling dengue and farmers who have to contend with pests in their fields. But the positive effects far outweigh them. Bugs, for example, provide the safest way to control pests in farms, no matter what those pesticide companies say. Most importantly, though, insects are charged with helping plants pollinate, without which they couldn't reproduce and we would not have food. In fact, bees, the most prolific pollinators, are said to be responsible for 1 out of every 3 meals that we eat. Not only is the honey from their hives really sought after, but they also help cultivate fruits and veggies worth $265 billion globally. But that great food service is threatened. The bee population all over the world has fallen up to 90% in places. This sudden disappearance has been called as colony collapse disorder, where hives upon hives die out suddenly. But why is this happening? The environmentalists claim that it is the neonicotinoid in the fertilizers that's causing this. The dominant chemical in most modern fertilizers, neonicotinoid, damages the bee's nervous system and makes them vulnerable to all sorts of parasites. Once they get inside the hives, it causes large-scale bee deaths. You can't fault the bees for not organizing themselves for success, though. Hives contain about 60,000 bees at its peak, mostly females dedicated to the service of the queen bee, the only one who reproduces. Bees are so practical that male drones are kicked out of hives after they've mated with the queen bee. Bees don't need dads, apparently. But speaking of industrial insects, no one can match up with the ants. An anthill colony can contain up to 5 lakh ants at a time, all of them with a clearly defined space in society. There are wingless female workers, the large soldier ants, a bunch of fertile males called the drones. They are all ruled by a single super fertile queen who lives twice as long as any of them. Ants are literally found everywhere except for the Antarctica. It probably has a lot to do with their hard-working, cooperative nature. In fact, the worker ants pretty much spend their entire lives working for the queen without even sleeping. Now that's dedication. Their domination of Earth can probably only be matched by cockroaches. They've been around for 320 million years and the experience shows. Apart from nuclear holocausts, cockroaches can also survive for long periods without food or water. And when it comes to eating, they can nibble at leather, soap, or even glue from postage stamps. Rotting food remains the favorite though. The more rotted, the better. Sometimes our relationship with roaches becomes a little too intimate. Now get ready to be grossed out, because apparently most foods contain cockroach bits in them. Food safety boards across the world recognize the fact and only limit the number of cockroach bits in food, not ban them completely. It gets more shocking, because of the almost 1 million species of insects, 1,500 are supposed to be a regular part of our diet. The diet we don't even really know about, that is. These little creatures usually fly into your mouth and into your food without you even realizing. Or maybe you did and you liked it. At this point, we're not sure anymore. Insect life is usually short and harsh. What with all these predators trying to eat you? The fact that they manage to keep up their numbers in the face of such hostility says a lot about their reproductive skills. Like termite queens from Southeast Asia, which lay up to 7,000 eggs a day. Insects are good at beating the odds. Others have cool modifications to confuse predators. It's why butterflies come in all those sparkling colors. In fact, a few butterflies also have listening devices on their wings to stay clear of bats. Some, like the Japanese honeybees, they even fight together to beat much bigger opponents like hornets. Not only do these organisms help us live by cultivating our plants, but they also have quite a few lessons to teach us about work ethics and teamwork. If only we could be as selfless as the ant, as tolerant as cockroaches or as brave as honeybees, a lot of our problems would be solved. We leave you with that food for thought. Like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel and tell us what insect-like ability you wish you had in the comment section below. Hey, remember, being Spider-Man doesn't count. So if you're going to be brave enough and get onto a Bombay train during peak hours and this is your first time ever on the trains, don't.
In festivals like Ganesh Chaturthi and Durga Puja, we see people worshipping huge idols of Ganesh and Durga. On the last days of the festivals, these idols are immersed in water.